If you're someone who's in a pattern of sneaking drinking and hiding drinks from your loved ones, maybe you've got stashes put away or you have a few drinks before you go to a party just to show up with a nice buzz. If this is you, I just want you to know that you're not alone. There's a lot of us out there who have struggled with secret drinking and hiding drinking. And I know that there's a lot of shame that can go along with it, but also there's this feeling like we're getting away with something that we shouldn't be doing. So in some ways, there's like this rush or this enjoyment. And I found that sneaking drinks can almost become its own type of addiction in a way when we're struggling with alcohol. And honestly, I know for me that I never wanted anyone to tell me what I could drink, when I could drink, how much I could drink. And so the way that I would prevent this from happening is I would sneak drinking behind everyone else's back so that maybe my husband would see me have two glasses of wine in front of him, but he didn't know that I was taking shots of whiskey behind his back or that I had, drinks before we went out that he didn't see me have. And I can talk about this so openly now because it's something that's behind me. This definitely wasn't something I was talking about in the midst of me doing it. I would not talk about it because it would kill my ability to be able to sneak my drinks and hide it from everyone around me. But I want to talk about it because I think it's something that a lot of people struggle with. A lot of normal people who have normal lives and are successful in life and have friends and families, but they have this kind of thorn in their side of struggling with alcohol and struggling with secret drinking. The way that I overcame this personally was through a science-based treatment that I used that helped me actually reduce my drinking by ultimately giving me more control when I drank, so that my desire to drink to excess and binge drink and have, two or three bottles of wine when everyone else is having two or three glasses, I got to a place where my desire for alcohol was just decreasing so that I would have one or two or three glasses and I would feel satisfied. I didn't feel the need to drink more and get drunk. So what I found through this treatment is that over time, as my interest and desire in alcohol just kind of went away and I saw myself have more control, I naturally stopped hiding my drinking because it just wasn't necessary anymore, because I could drink as much as I wanted to, and that became, like a couple of drinks. It wasn't a couple of bottles of wine anymore. And so this treatment is called the Sinclair Method. It's an incredibly powerful science-based protocol. It's been around for 30 years, but a lot of people still don't know about it. I think really that's because a lot of treatments for alcohol dependence want you to just quit drinking and abstain. And this treatment actually allows you to keep drinking and it helps you to reduce your drinking over time. You can learn more about it with the other videos I have, or the link in my profile has resources and information as well. Hope this helps.